Hello and welcome back. Some of you might have noticed that there on the resources page I've shown you on the Arduino.cc, yeah, said okay, watch two resources, go to reference. On this reference page, there is also digital read, there's digital write, there's pin mode. We know those commands, yeah. And there is also an interesting part, analog I/O. Analog read, analog write. Yeah. So it seems like our Arduino can also output or read analog values. So not only 0 and 5 volt, but something between. Between 0 and 5 volt. So first, what do we want to do? We want to write something. Okay. So we press on the write command. There's a lot of stuff written. Here we have the syntax. Yeah. So it pretty much looks like the digital write. It says just analog write, pin and value. And below you have the information. The Arduino pin to write to. Allowed type data types are int. Okay, so we need to tell a pin number. IO pin number, and there's a value, and this is the so-called duty cycle. What this means, so 0 is always off, 255 is maximum output. You can give somewhere between 0 and 255. Okay, if you would put in 128, it's around the middle. Good. It is necessary to know that not all I/O pins of our Arduino are able to make an analog output. If we look at our Arduino, you will notice for sure some of these pins, like here the 3, the 5, the 6, the 9, the 10 and the 11, they are marked with some small tilde signs. Yeah, looks a little bit like a minus tilde signs. These are the I/O pins which can be used as analog outputs. Okay. In the introduction, I said it's not really analog, it's a so-called PWM, pulse width modulation signal. What this means, we will learn pretty soon. Yeah. What do we want to do? I again want to do it with an LED, because we know how LED is working, we know how to use it. So now we want to make the LED not just lit, we want to make it darker, lighter, from 0 to maximum value in brightness. Okay? We want to adjust the brightness. So I will make again and hardware setup, use the LED, plug it between minus and one pin, use again a series resistor, of course, yeah, because we don't want to burn the LED. Pull it in. Then of course I need to again make my bridges here, that we have our supply everywhere we need it. Even if I don't need it, I will switch my power supply to 5 volts. Again to here, and the ground again to here, because then I have multiple pins available where I have 5 volt and ground. Okay, what I'm still missing is the line to light up my LED. Yeah. For testing purposes, I will now plug my Arduino in. Bim, bim, bim. Okay, Arduino comes online. I would try if I plug it into 5 volt, the LED is bright, so the hardware setup seems to be fine. And now I'm plugging this into pin number 3. I'm selecting pin number 3, not 2 like before. I'm using 3 because 3 is marked with this tilde sign, and I want to do an output. Okay, we want to do an analog output, and 3 is capable of doing analog outputs. Also, on the Arduino page, you can see which pins are able. It's marked on the Arduino hardware, but if you don't have the Arduino hardware at hand, you can just look it up in the specs. And our Uno can do it on the pins 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11. Yeah? Just like we just read on the board itself. Other Arduino boards might do it on different pins, pin number. Okay? You need to check there. Okay. So let's start our Arduino software for programming. That's our last program. We will make a new program. So I'll simply press the button new. Here we go. There's the new program. I will immediately save it with a current name, with a good name. I will call it 3ABH, my name 08 analog out. I will call it analog out. Back. There we go. Okay, so we'll again do it with my compile time constants. Yeah, I will make a define. And pin number, I was called it LED pin, yeah, and this is now 3. I again have to set this as an output, so I write pin mode, LED pin, pin number 3 needs to be an output. Output, okay, now I got it right. Control T makes it beautiful, yeah. Pin number 3 is an output. That's about it. Yeah. And here I want to make the LED start at 0, then I want to make it brighter, and then I want to make it less bright again. So I need some value which I can manipulate. Okay. This value here is written, the value needs to be an integer. Yeah. We know an integer should not be an issue for us, so I will just make an int, of course a static, because I don't want that this integer is changing its value, and I say value. It's called well, why not? Starting by 0. Okay. Now I'm using something new. I'm using a so-called for loop. Okay. For well should look like this. What does this mean? At the beginning, the value should be 0. Yeah? The value should always be smaller than 255, and as long as this is, with every loop through this for, with every loop through this for will increase the value by 1. Yeah? So in the beginning it's 0, runs through the loop, starts over, looks, it's still smaller than 255, add 1, it's 1, run through the loop, back, back, back. And the loop runs until the value has reached the value of bigger than 255 or not smaller than 255, which means the value means equal to 255. And then we will continue the program after the loop. Okay. So here I just make an analog write. I have to spell it correct, of course. Analog write at the pin number 3 and with the value. Okay. And because our arena is incredible fast, I will code a delay here. Let's say I will just call it delay well, and I will again do it with a define. And I will say 20 milliseconds, maybe. Yeah. So now value is 0, we write out 0, LED should be dark. After 20 milliseconds, we start over, value gets 1. Value should be a little bit more than dark. Then we have 2, value should be 2, the LED should be a little bit more than dark and so on. And we end up where the value is 255. That's it. Yeah. So now the last thing we write here is LED pin value 254. Almost full bright. Yeah. I just copy this now. And as now, let's start the value at 255 and let's say it's bigger than 0. And now we should go minus minus. What does this mean? Now the value starts at 255 and is counting down. So here we're starting at full brightness and decreasing the brightness with every loop through until we have reached 1. Then we're at the end because 1 is still bigger than 0. Then value minus minus is 0. 0 is not bigger than 0, so we at the end we start over and here 0. Okay. Since I've always using the whole value and the value is here at the beginning, I don't really care about the value which was in val here. I can remove the static. It does not bother me. Okay. And I'm already a little bit eager to see how this looks like, especially with the camera. Okay, so I will compile it now. It will download. Okay, now it's downloading. I guess you cannot see it very good on the camera. I will try to decrease my delay to 10 milliseconds, that it's going a little bit faster. Download. With the bright eye, I can see the LED is brightening up quite bright and then it's going down and it's getting dark, and it's really going smooth, as you can see on the screen. Yeah. Unfortunately, there is not much difference between the medium bright and the real bright LED setting, but with the naked eye, you will see this is working pretty well. So it's getting dark, then it's getting brighter and brighter. And even with the naked eye, there's not much difference in a medium bright and totally bright. What is happening here? Yeah. It's not the current. Yeah. It's not the current which is changing. Yeah. It's something else. What is it? You have a description here also. You have a description here also on the Arduino WPM wave, yeah. And the thing looks like this. It's also in the script. I will show you there because I like it a little bit better. A little bit better. Giveaway picture. That's the BBM rate, let's say. BBM rate. The BBM rate is different on each output. And if we are setting it to zero, so this would be value of zero, then the LED is never ever turned on. Okay. If we're switching it to 255, the LED is always on. Yeah. And if we are switching it to some value between, let's say to around 128, to around the middle, 50%, then half of the time the LED is on and half of the time the LED is off. Then it's on again, off again, on again, off again, always with the frequency of the pulse width modulation, PWM. Yeah. If we are even smaller than 125, 28, so around what would be 20%, 10% is 25, so around 50, it would look like this. Yeah, really short turning it on, and then a long time turning it off. Then really short turning it on, a long time turning it off. If we are using 80%, so that then would be around 200, a value around 200. It's pretty long turned on, and then short turn off. Then pretty long turned on, short turn off. Yeah? That's the so-called duty cycle. Yeah? 100% duty cycle, so 100% load. 0% duty cycle is no load. And something else between, there is just on, off very fast. And the portion between on and off time is simply the percentage which we can adjust. Yeah? Every new on time starts at the fixed rate. Yeah? On each pin of the Arduino, this is different. For instance, on pin number 3, we used right here, we are around 500 Hz, 490 Hz. So this spike here is happening around 500 times per second, 490 times per second. Yeah. Really fast, much too fast for our eye. But maybe not too fast for some cameras. And that's the issue. A camera might take a picture here, take a picture here, take a picture here, also here, 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 and it always looks bright. Okay? And then suddenly, in the next frame, it takes a picture here, and it is dark. And here, and it's again dark, and again dark. And so it takes some pictures where it is lit and some pictures where it's dark, and suddenly it does not look like it's just not bright, it looks like blinking. Yeah, you maybe have noticed this if you filming a fancy new car with LED headlights, and these headlights look to blink on your video, they look really stupid and ugly sometimes. Yeah, they make some patterns and blinking and so on, and with the naked eye you cannot see. This is exactly the reason. Yeah? Because they also do pulse width modulation there, yeah, to make them bright or not so bright, depending what they need right now. Yeah. And well, sometimes your handy camera or your camera pictures the LED exactly at the right moment that it looks bright, and moments later looks dark because it just takes pictures during the dark time. Maybe we can see this even with our camera here. I will try to change the code. So let's see if we set this delay value to 200 milliseconds. Then we have around 200 milliseconds per step. Maybe we can see it better than download. Let's see what's happening. You notice this blinking? Now it's getting brighter and brighter. Right now it's not changing on the screen. Now it should get darker again. And you will notice flickering at this LED. You will notice flickering when it's getting dark again. You will notice flickering, and this is exactly the effect I told you before. This is exactly when the booth width modulation, when the camera is photographing the LED lit or not lit with a certain pattern. Some elements are lit, and some frames are not lit, and suddenly the LED appears to be blinking, or in this case flickering a little bit. Well, it takes pretty much time when we are using 200 delay time. Every step takes 200 milliseconds now. Takes a while. Let's see if it's worth waiting. I'm already eager to see. It's getting dark. You see it's flickering. Tick, 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 tick. This, with the naked eye, you will not see this. Yeah? So you see the effect of the pulse width modulation. Yeah? You see the effect of the pulse width modulation. Remember, this pulse width modulation is this cycle here, yeah? 0%, 20%, 50%, 80%, 100%. Yeah? You have to keep this in mind. Every LED is dimmed like this. Yeah? So if you are experiencing some strange feelings underneath an LED stripe or something like this, it's could maybe be around this, because this flickering we are not noticing, but our eye might even trigger an epileptic shock, epileptic rage, or I don't know how to call it, epileptischer Anfall. Yeah. Could be possible, but it's very rarely, because it's really, really, really fast. Yeah. Usually a booth width modulation is not just done with 500 Hz, it's much faster, yeah, some kilohertz. Yeah. However, what might be an issue is rotating, spinning drives. Okay. Because it is in fact the case that the drive or the part is just lit some portion, some small portion of a second, and then it's dark again, and then it's lit again, and it's dark again. I'm not sure if somebody of you, or most of you, I guess, have ever seen a stroboscope in the disco, where every move looks like tick, 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 very, very abgehackt, yeah, very suddenly moving, yeah, just short strokes of flash. Short flash stroke, and then it's dark, and then a short flash stroke, then you see it moving like the person would move in steps. Okay, stroboscope. And this might happen also with these pulse modulation devices, because it's nothing else than a stroboscope. Short light, the nothing, short like the nothing. So our eye would see only this time the rotating element. Then it does not see anything. And then only this time the rotating element, and that does not see anything. And then only this time, and so on and so on and so on. Yeah. And it might happen the case that the rotation speed of a shaft or whatever is exactly in sync with the PWM cycle. So that you always light up the rotating part at the correct moment, yeah, that it appears to you as it would stand still. And that's the dangerous thing. In reality, this thing is turning at enormous speed, and because you are using an LED lightning, flickering LED lightning with PWM, yeah, it appears to be in standstill. Okay? This is why some LED lights are not allowed at rotating machinery. Yeah? Turning, milling, something like this. Yeah? There needs to be a special light. This is exactly the reason. Anyway, small side information. Here we now have our change it again to 10, that we can see it coming on and off again. Yeah. Now we coded an LED which is not just on and off. We can make it brighter or not so bright. That was fulfilled. In the script, you also have all this information inside. Yeah, you even have the program inside. There it's written with static, like I said, it's really not necessary. Now, what's your task? You should include again this little button, yeah, and whenever you press the button, the light or the brightness of the LED should be changed. Yeah. So if you press the button, it should get brighter. Then if you release the button, it should stay at this brightness where you are. And if you then press the button again, it should get darker. So every second time it should get darker, every second time it should get brighter. And so you could adjust the brightness of the LED with just one button. This is how it should work. There is the button now. There is the LED. If I press and hold the button, the LED is getting brighter. Okay? If I press and hold the button a second time, the LED is getting darker. So I can adjust the value of the LED. Yeah? Some of you might also implement the following function if I not press and hold the button or just press and release the button. It should turn off. If I press and release the button, it should use the same brightness as before. And then if I press and hold the button, I should again be able to change the brightness. Okay. Short press, off, short press, on. Long press, change the brightness in how you wish. This with the short press is not that important. This should only the people try who are pretty sure they can solve it. Yeah. With the brightness adjustment with the button, this should work for almost everyone, because this is really not that easy, or not that, sorry, it's not that difficult, yeah? Not that complicated. So this is your task. Hopefully you will fulfill it. Should not be too difficult. Let's see. Okay. So thanks for your time. Thanks for listening. Have fun. Goodbye.